Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can trigger certain actions in a Blender animation using a music source. So what I'm doing in the video you're looking at is actually triggering different ones of these little puffs of smoke based on different frequency ranges within the music source. So I'll quickly go through and demonstrate how this is done. If you enjoy these tutorials, don't forget to click like and subscribe. Feel free to comment or ask questions or even dislike the video. And if you don't like the video, I'd be very interested to see what the issues you spotted were so that I can improve going forward. If you're a Patreon supporter, I do upload these files for any use available to my Patreon supporters, and I upload tutorials quite regularly. So let's start the tutorial. So to begin with, let's just make our source. I'll just put a little plane down. We'll scale it up a bit. And we'll subdivide it, and we'll add a little variability with the fractal here as well. So for this demonstration, we'll just pick 3 points. Press O to turn on proportional editing, and we'll set it to sharp, and then GZ, and then I've clicked and GZ and shrink in the influence a bit just to give it that little hole at the top, and I'll set that to shade smooth. So we've got three sort of shoots there. And I'll just give that a simple material, and we'll put that in the viewport as well. So we'll call that ground. So I'll just add a simple icosphere. I think I'm just going to cut the top of that icosphere off, and we'll call that smoke emit, and we'll color it black color with a high roughness so it doesn't really have any reflection. And we'll make that a bit smaller. And I'll just put that roughly here within the crater. It doesn't matter too much. Now, this is going to be what actually emits the smoke in our scene, but we now need a domain to go with that. So I'm going to add mesh cube. You can use quick effects for this, but I decided just to go through the smoke simulation element manually for this exercise. So I'm just lifting it up and close everything. It doesn't need to be too big, but it doesn't matter too much. And we'll call that domain. I'm going to come to here, and under viewport visibility, I'll just go back to solid view there, and under viewport display, I'm just going to say wire so we can see the domain, but it doesn't get in the way of what we're looking at. So we now come up to here, physics properties. So all I'm doing at the moment is just creating a scene and adding a smoke simulator. I'm come here to physics properties, and we'll say fluid and change this to domain. Leave it on gas. We'll leave it on those divisions at the moment. We'll have no border collisions, so any smoke that gets out the top or reaches the top is just going to escape. And we'll turn on adaptive domain, which means it will vary the size of the domain to be no bigger than it needs to be. And this little cube in the bottom left here is obviously the smallest size for our volumetric pixels, in other words, voxels. So now I need to select my little smoke emit object, click fluid under physics properties for that. But this time this is a flow source. We'll leave it on smoke. At geometry, it will just create smoke from the object. It's not really showing at the moment, but that's all that's doing. So what I want is I want to set this to inflow, which means it will continually produce smoke unless controlled to do otherwise. So there, you can see it now. If I go back to geometry, it just uses the geometry itself to create, as it were, a sort of puff of smoke, and that's it. So inflow is what we need, but this use flow option here is what actually controls whether it's emitting smoke. So you can see I'm going to set the end of our simulation to 500 frames, so we've got a bit more time. And if I turn off use flow, you can see it stops emitting smoke, even though what has been emitted carries on rising. So this is the key to how we're going to turn that smoke on and off. If I go back to the domain, come down to the cache, make sure that the frame end is as long as your animation. So I've got 500, so I've set that to 500. So that's the start. We're almost ready to get to the music section now. So I'll call up the graph editor, and I'll select my smoke emitter again. And I'm actually going to duplicate that smoke emitter now. I'm going to put one there, and I'm going to put one there. So we've got three, and I'm going to change the names now. So the first one's going to be 300 next to that, hertz as it happens. So that one is going to be frequencies below 300 hertz. The next one will say 300 to 700 hertz. Hertz being cycles per second, it's the frequency of the sound, obviously. And then the last one, I'll just call it 700 hertz, but of course it will be frequencies above that. I did about half a dozen different frequency bands, so we know what we're dealing with there now. So I'm just going to turn off the flows. So now when I press play, there's no smoke emitted because they're all turned off. I'm going to press I on frame one, hovering over the use flow for each of them. Probably should have done this before I copied them. So that's now created a keyframe at the start of my animation at a value which means flow is off. And I'm going to click in here and I'm just going to go to video editing. It's just a quick way to do this. And I'm going to add sound. And this is the piece of music I used, which is royalty free from YouTube. So I'm just going to import that. So you can see it's appeared as a clip down here. If I press play, you can hear it playing and it's set to the beginning of my animation. So if I go back to layout now, when I play through, I get the music playing, which is great. So back to the beginning of the animation, I'll select my 300 Hertz emitter and now go up to channel. Make sure that the use flow option is still selected, which it should be. Go up to channel, sound to samples. They've changed it slightly from earlier versions of Blender. And again, I need to go and pick my music file. Now, before I click the sound to samples button down here, let's have a look at some of the settings available over here on the right hand side. So lowest frequency zero. For this one, I want all the frequencies below 300 Hertz. So that's fine. And then we've got highest frequency. So that's currently set to 100 kilohertz, which is a bit on the high side. So I'm going to just set that to 300. Threshold I can leave at zero at the moment. You may need to play around with these a little bit and you may find you need to set it to square. So we'll just click sound to samples now. And you can see we've got something happening just here. So there obviously are some frequencies that are below the 300 Hertz here, but they're below the threshold where it's showing up at the moment. But you can now see when the bass drum starts up, we've got these points clicking through here. I think I'm going to extend this to 1000 now, just so we get a bit more of the music. And you can see it's brought those samples in anyway. So that's the lowest frequencies. We're back to the beginning. Now I'm going to select my mid-range. Again, make sure it's selected, make sure that the use flow keyframe is selected and channel sound to samples. This time we want to start at lowest frequency of 300 and we want our highest frequency. We've selected 700 here. It's a bit arbitrary. I haven't really tested this too much. And initially, let's just accept that, see what it looks like. As you get into the higher frequencies, you may need to play around with some of these other settings. So if you're having a bit of trouble getting it to detect anything, turn on square here, and then you can play around with this threshold. So let's try a threshold of 0.5. So that's obviously too high. Go for 0.2. And you can see we're starting to get something there. You probably will need to play around and have a look at what frequencies you're narrowing in on. See, that's giving us some pulses there, which are fine. So we'll now select our higher frequencies. I tried to select these in a way that would mean we caught quite a lot. The higher the frequencies are, the lower the amplitude tends to be. So for this one, we want 700 as the lowest frequency. Now, in theory, you should go up to 20,000. I think probably 15 is plenty. And let's see what that looks like. Again, you can see we've got nothing because of the amplitude. So we'll go up to sound to samples again, and we'll come down to 0.1 on the threshold, come right down. And there we go. Now we've got something at the beginning. So let's have a look at how that looks. And you may notice we're actually starting to get some smoke down here now. Won't be reactive enough for us to see it in the real-time view. But you can at least see that this one is starting to produce some smoke. That one did a little puff as well. And then to start to look at whether or not this is producing something which is working for you, it's worth doing a little animation at this point, still with the smoke simulation at a relatively low resolution. So at this point, what I would do is define a test file. Only need it to be RGB, but instead of PNG, I just did a video. Now, because you want to include the sound to make sure that it's syncing to the sound, you need to use a codec which is going to contain sound. FFmpeg video will do that. So you can see by default there's no audio, so I'll turn audio on and we'll just say MP3. You're not necessarily going to render your video out like this. It's up to you, but you do need to render it in a way that allows you to hear the sound and see the video at the same time. And then set this to something like 25%. So that's the overall size of the image. I did all of this in EV because it would take a very long time for my computer to do it in cycles. So under volumetrics, I did set this to 2 pixels quality so that we could actually see what was going on. I turned volumetric shadows on. I also added a lamp. In fact, I think I added a couple of lamps, but let's put a sun lamp into the scene and make sure it's at a reasonable level, something like 5. And we'll set the background to a very dark color. We have a look at what that's like, about like that, that's fine. And if we let it produce a bit of smoke. So at the moment, we don't have anything rendering for the smoke, so we need to do that. So if we come back here, you can see there's some smoke, but in the rendered view, it's not visible. So if we select our domain and go to the shader editor, we'll say new material, we'll get rid of the principled shader and we'll add principled volume. Obviously that plugs into volume. I'll set the smoke to white to make it nice and visible. And I increase the density a bit, but if we go to the, there we go. It just took a second to catch up. I'll just turn the grids off. So you can see there's some smoke there and I increase the density to something like 13 and I didn't change anything else. So we know we're going to produce some visible smoke now, which is what we need. I'll actually just set the range here to 300 at the moment and we'll render that to an animation and I'll be back when that's done. So once that's done, we can come up to here we can just say view animation and you can see it will bring it up and we can see how that did. And at the moment, it doesn't look very good because although it's triggering, it's just a continuous stream. It's not coming and going. So one of the first things we need to do is select our domain, go back to the beginning of the animation, under physics properties, turn on dissolve. This means the smoke only lasts for a moment or two and then it fades out. Maybe visible here. You can see it's pulsing there. I also turned on noise, which sort of simulates a higher resolution. And we'll put the scale of the animation up slightly. We'll go to 64. I used 128, which isn't that high. The other thing I did was I went into my individual emitters and added an initial velocity. And I added an initial velocity for Z of 25 meters per second. And that really just pushes the smoke out much more quickly. So I'll just do that for each of them. So it makes more of a sort of puff of smoke. So we'll give that another render and we'll see what that's like. Okay, that's rendered. So let's have a look at that. Now you can see we're getting those pulses. And you can see that they're synchronized with the music. We only just got to the end there. The only other few things I would say is once you're happy with it, obviously you're going to set this up to 100%. What you'll also want to do is go to your domain under physics properties and instead of replay, just say all and then you can tell it to bake all. And if you click bake on there, once you've got all your settings where you want them, click bake on there and it will pre-calculate the simulation. So it's not doing it as it works through. When I created this, I actually rendered out to just PNG format, so simple image files. And then when I compiled that, I added the sound back. But if you want to just render to a video the way I just did, that'll work too. So I hope you found that interesting. If you did, let me know. If you've got any questions, comments or observations, happy to read those in the comments below. I will upload the original source file with a few extra little details in it, such as some GeoNode rocks and things that I also added to that other one. And I'll upload that for my Patreon supporters to use for any purpose. Otherwise, I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.